Now let's talk about how to apply Gauss's law in a cylindrical case. We're going to analyze a cylindrical charge distribution, rho v, that is 7r coulombs per meter cubed. That means that the charge distribution gets stronger the further away I get from the z-axis. The charge distribution is some kind of a cylinder that has a radius of 1 meters. This is like a plasma tube. The cylindrical charge distribution is going to be infinitely long. That means it will go from z equals minus infinity up to z equals infinity. And I want to be able to find the electric flux density inside the cylinder or outside the cylinder. Well, the first thing we need to do is find a Gaussian surface that is symmetric for this particular case. Well, so far, the charge distribution is symmetric. It's a function of r, which means it gets stronger as I get away from the z-axis, but it does not vary with phi. So the questions that I'm going to ask myself is, does this vary with phi? And if it does vary with phi, if the answer is yes, then I'm going to go to Coulomb's law instead of Gauss's law for the electric field. The other thing that I'm going to ask myself is, does it vary with z? Now here there are two choices. If the answer is yes, and I am not in the center, then I'm going to have to use Coulomb's law. If the answer is no, or the answer is that I am in the center, then I can use Gauss's law. Let me show you what I mean. Let's suppose that we had a cylindrical charge distribution that had rho v equals 7r times z. And let's say that we wanted to find the electric flux density right here at z equal to 0. Would this be symmetric or would it not? Well, as I move up in the z direction, my charge is going to get more and more positive. And as I move down in the z direction, the charge is going to get more and more negative. The answer is no. This is going to have to be a Coulomb's law case. But let's suppose that instead I had 7r times the magnitude of z. In that case, as I went up, my charge would increase, and as I went down, my charge would increase equally. If I wanted to find the electric flux right here at the center, then I would be able to use Gauss's law. What if instead I wanted to be able to find z, I wanted to be able to find my electric flux up here, someplace near the end of my cylinder? The answer then would be that no, if I wanted to find my value at z equals some distance, I would have to use Coulomb's law. The reason I would have to do that is because any place that I move, here is one value of z, here is another, and here is another, all of those values are going to have different magnitudes of the electric flux. They are not symmetric, they are not uniform, and I cannot use Gauss's law. So now we have definitely looked to see if we have a symmetric case. And the answer for our case is yes. So we're going to design a Gauss's surface that encloses all of the charge that I'm interested in. So my electric flux, my Gaussian surface, is the place that I want to find my electric flux. So if I want to find my electric flux outside, I'm going to use a Gaussian surface like this. And if I wanted to find my electric flux inside, then this would be the Gaussian surface that I would choose. So I'm going to choose my Gaussian surface two ways. I need to be sure that my system is symmetric. That means that my magnitude of d is going to be equal every place on this surface. The other thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to choose my Gaussian surface so that d is on the surface. Now let's go and actually apply that to this particular problem to find the electric flux inside and outside of my cylinder.